Two of the main crypto assets people know when they get into cryptocurrency is Bitcoin and Ethereum. Most people know Bitcoin as like the digital gold and Ethereum as your smart contract platform. But between me and you, paying $20 minimum or, I don't know, sometimes even $150 for a transaction is not very smart to me. Now, I'm not hating on Ethereum. I like Ethereum. Ethereum is cool. But I wonder if that was the original vision of the Ethereum team. Now I'll go ahead and spoil the surprise. Gavin Wood, one of the main developers behind Ethereum, actually saw several problems with Ethereum and sought out to make his own project. In today's KuCoin DigiDive, we're going to be talking about Polkadot. We're going to go over what the team is looking to do. We're going to go over a couple of examples of some of the DeFi protocols, and we're going to give an overview of the project. If you guys would like to get started trading with this coin, links in the description below, and you guys can get 20% off trading fees. So the first thing we need to do, let's go over Polkadot. What is Polkadot? Well, the TLDR on Polkadot is that it's a smart contract platform that is allowing interoperability through multiple chains. And how it's doing this is with its parachain technology. I'll explain that later in this video, but one of the main problems with Ethereum and why it's always congested outside of transaction speeds and block space is that all of the different dApps have to follow under one module. Every single dApp is built under one chain. So you can have a lending protocol, you can have a NFT platform, you can have a GameFi platform. All of these are built on the main Ethereum layer. This is a problem because if you have some guy or some person that's just trying to mint a random NFT and then someone who's about to get liquidated for, I don't know, $500 million because of the price fluctuations and they need to repay their loan, but they're unable to do it because the chain is congested, that's a serious problem. Now, I mean, that's fine. Like, NFTs are important, they're fun, but I mean, are they as important as a $500 million liquidation? Obviously, I think we know the answer to this, but the guy minting that NFT, he could care less about that $500 million loan. He wants that NFT. So Polkadot is looking to solve this problem by allowing each project to have its own chain, which is called a parachain. So with these parachains, these are all interoperable with each other. So if I have some funds over in this DeFi lending protocol, like Akala, and I want to bring it over to another protocol, like Parallel Finance or even Fala Network, which is a privacy network, I can move it between those chains using the relay chain on Polkadot. So I can hop from these different chains and it's a seamless process. But yet, these are still separate from each other. So if the Fala Network goes down or they have issues on their chain, that's not my problem. Their chain is down, I'm over on Akala, so I'm still doing my same junk, different day over here. So this is why interoperability is important. One project and one protocol can't crash the whole entire chain for everyone else. Now, there are other projects that are looking to operate with interoperability in mind. Another one is called Cosmos. Cosmos takes a little bit different approach than Polkadot. Well, let's go and explain how Polkadot works. The best way to understand Polkadot is going through the terminology. This is a general overview or a scale view of the Polkadot platform. There are different pieces of the pie we're going to go ahead and break down. The relay chain, which is this main gray little symbol that goes around, this connects all the different dApps with each other. Then you have the parachains. These are going to be your separate blockchains. So this would be like Akala, this would be Parallel Finance, this would be Fala, or if you guys are trying to put it in terminologies like on Ethereum, it would be like Aave, it would be like Compound, it would be like Uniswap, SushiSwap. The parachains are the different blockchains on there. The parachains are these little squares. So these are each of the different blockchains, or you can call them dApps if you want to, but they have their own blockchain. And if that chain goes down, it does not affect the rest of the network. So let me show you guys the para threads. So these allow a more economical approach for other chains that don't need continuous connectivity to the network. So the parachains actually have two separate options. They have a pay-as-you-go model, and then they also have a rent service. The rent service is what they call the Polkadot parachain auctions. In order for a project to become a parachain, they must participate in an auction, and the community goes and votes for them to be in the auction. They vote by doing this with their DOT. So they put their DOT up as a stake and say, hey, look, I'm staking my DOT with you for the next 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, whatever funding round it is. And usually these different parachains will say, that's awesome. We'll give you tokens in exchange for believing in us. They're called the parachain auctions. And this is how a project or a protocol would get one of these parachains. Now, these are not permanent, so keep that in mind. That's also one of the differentiators between Polkadot and Cosmos. Cosmos, you have your own chain. You don't have to rent out your space and it's all interoperable. However, on Cosmos, you don't have the network security from Polkadot. Cosmos, each of the different dApps have to secure their own network with their own token. Whereas on Polkadot, the parachains don't need to do that. They're renting the space. So the DOT token is actually going to secure the network. I'll get into the DOT token with later details. Here's another visual so you guys can view what the Polkadot ecosystem looks like. This relay chain is able to allow all of these different parachains to communicate with each other. Each of the parachains is able to bridge up to the relay chain. And say, for example, this parachain here is Aave. And I get my loan. I want to go ahead and buy a NFT on, let's say, OpenSea or any other project that has its own chain. So what I would do is I'd bridge from the relay chain and move into the next chain here. It's literally a bridge, but instead of depending on a third party, it's built into the system. We know how many times bridges get hacked, and that's due to a third party being involved. So now that we kind of have a higher level overview of Polkadot and how the parachain and how the whole ecosystem is set up, let's go ahead and talk about this DOT token. What can you use the DOT token for? Well, first it's used for governance. So you can use the Polkadot token in order to vote and say, hey, look, this is where I think the Polkadot network needs to go. This is important for directing the future of the project in general. You can also stake the DOT token. Staking is used to A, secure the network, and B, provide the ability in order to create network security through slashing. So if someone is staking their token and they're a bad operator and try to double spend or they try to do something malicious on the network, their tokens will be slashed. So it's a way of saying, hey, look, here's my skin in the game. I'm going to do right. If I do wrong, you're going to destroy me. The next feature is bonding. This is in order to participate in the parachain auctions. Say, for example, I see a project, let's say it's Fala Network, and I'm like, man, I really want you guys to get a parachain. So what I would do is I'd say, hey, look, here's my DOT. And usually Fala Network or any of the protocols will say, hey, look, we like your appreciation. Here's some of our tokens as a good gesture for believing in us. That's what you can do with the Polkadot token. You don't lose the DOT token. It's just locked up. So say the auction or the time frame for that parachain lasts 2 years. Your DOT tokens are locked with them for 2 years. Some projects actually get a little more creative, like Akala. Akala, when you gave them your DOT tokens, they give you a receipt saying, hey, look, thanks for your DOT tokens. Here's a liquid stake token. So this basically says, hey, I bonded with Akala. You got tokens for doing that, but you also got to keep your DOT. So you now have some collateral you can borrow against and still participate in DeFi. Because when you lock up those DOT tokens, you can't borrow against those. But with Akala, they give you a liquid token that actually has some value behind it and you can borrow against it. So now that you guys understand the structure of the Polkadot ecosystem, what the DOT token is looking to do, let me go ahead and show you guys a couple of projects built on Polkadot. On polkadotproject.com, you guys can actually go under the All page. I'll leave a link in the description below. And you can scroll through all these different projects that are being built on Polkadot. Now, all of these don't have their own dApp, but you can see these are just all the different protocols in general. If you want to specify and say, hey, I only want to see the projects that are being built on Polkadot, you can actually do this by clicking substrate based. Fala Network, Math Chain, Energy Web, Ocean Protocol. These are different projects that are built on Polkadot. I want to show you guys Akala Network. As you guys can see here on Akala Network, I went ahead and loaded up some tokens. Well, not loaded up, but I put one on here just to show you guys a little bit how it works. If I wanted to bridge different tokens into here and I click this bridge feature, this will allow me to bring tokens from Polkadot, from Akala. This will allow me to bridge back and forth. Once I go to Polkadot, which is the relay chain, I can go ahead and bring my tokens now that are on the main Polkadot chain and put them into any project I want. So right now I have some tokens on Akala. So if I wanted to bridge my tokens out from Akala onto Polkadot, I can do that. I can say, hey, I want to go ahead and bridge all of my DOT tokens. I don't have any DOT tokens in here, but I wanted to bridge one DOT token. It would allow me to transfer my DOT all the way onto the Polkadot chain. Now I wanted to come over to Parallel Finance. What you would do when you have some assets on the Relay chain, this will allow you to deposit and withdraw here. It'll say it here. It's the same UI UX type of thing on the bridge, and you'll be able to deposit and withdraw from Parallel Finance. Now, Parallel Finance is a money market. It's a swapping feature. It allows liquid staking. There's different features involved with this. It's just the same UI UX you know and love, but it has interoperability in mind. So I can do all my borrowing and lending and all kinds of stuff on Parallel Finance and bring it over to Akala if I wanted to. I can also go over on Akala since this is like a MakerDAO type of platform, and I can take my LC DOT and mint some AUSD against it. All I would have to do is create in a vault and I would use my LC DOT. So I'd select LC DOT, I would do next, and I can mint some AUSD. If I do the max, it'll allow me to do 2.83 because that's the collateral value. Now, of course, I can get liquidated as well, so I do need to watch this measure, but this is just how you guys can use it. Once I get some of my AUSD, I can choose whatever I want with it. If I want to go buy some DOT tokens, I can actually swap my 2.38 AUSD that I just borrowed and buy some more DOT. And this DOT, I can go ahead and bring to the Relay chain and also bring it back to Parallel Finance. So it's the same stuff you know and love, but it's now interoperable. I don't have to go on a bridge like Seller Network or on AnySwap bridge or even on Synapse bridge. That's really annoying. And on top of that, that is major network security risk. And on top of that, there's a lot of risks with bridges. We're talking billions of dollars being hacked in total for all of the bridges in general. Losing $1 billion, that's not really safe to me. So having something with the security built into the chain is important. So aligning incentives and having the bridge built into the chain is something important for network security. Now you have another one called Moonbeam. There's also a partner called Moon River. Moon River is smart contracts built on Kusama. Kusama is the same thing as Polkadot, but it has a couple things that are different, mainly in general that it's faster and the staking times are not as long. It's just a test chain to make sure everything works or things are actually able to be tested before it brings on the daddy chain, which is Polkadot. So it's basically just a sister chain for testing to see if it works. So what are my closing thoughts on Polkadot? Well, I think it's a really interesting project. I like how it has interoperability in mind, and I like how some of these projects, especially if they don't want to provide network security for their chain, they can actually depend on the Polkadot network to provide that network security and do what they do best and do it well, which is, well, have a DeFi project or NFT project or a GameFi platform that is doing its best to make it something that we all know and love. Now, this project's not looking to replace Ethereum. It's actually looking to be interoperable with Ethereum. So it can interoperate with Ethereum through Moonbeam because that's its bridge from Ethereum onto the Polkadot network. So in my opinion, I actually believe these projects can coexist with each other. When I say these projects, I'm talking about Ethereum, Polkadot, and other networks looking to build on Polkadot with its interoperability feature. Before we end this video, I want to go over one important part that a lot of people need to look in altcoins, especially with the external market circumstances, aka bear market. What are the project's runway? If you look on Polkadot, this was a tweet from Gavin Wood back on October 17th. Sure, this was 6 months ago, but the treasury consisted of 18,936,300 DOT, which of course the price of that back from this tweet was way more than it is now, but right now the prices of Polkadot are around $9, or the DOT token $9. So you can say here roughly $150 million worth of DOT. Now that's a lot of money, that's a good runway, but as always there are concerns with this because it's priced in the DOT token. If the DOT token goes to zero, we're just putting it out in all intents and purposes. They have no treasury. Now, of course, they do have funds on the balance sheet. They actually raised over $170 million back in 2017 to fund their project. So in my opinion, I think they are very well funded and have enough runway for the next bull market. Of course, this is not financial advice, but just wanted to point this out to you guys. Let's go ahead and hit you guys with a wisdom one-liner. Proverbs chapter 14, verses 9. Fools mock at making amends for sin, but goodwill is found amongst the upright. If someone does you wrong, do right back to them. See what happens. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for tuning in. If you guys enjoyed this KuCoin DigiDive, make sure you guys hit that like, subscribe, and if you guys are ready to go ahead and get started trading with this coin, you guys can get 20% off trading fees. And if you guys would like to try some of the different dApps like Parallel Finance or even Akala, I'll leave links in the description below so you guys can check those out now. You can see some of our previous videos here, 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 and like there.